And everyone sing from here? Because
I think it's okay.
Or you could use the whole stage. Or just waltz around him.
Yeah, you can dance if you want.
You can still talk while you dance.
Okay, let's start.
All right, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Manu Escobar. I'm a chemical engineer and I'm a data scientist. So usually when we think about data, that's what comes to mind, right? Pretty easy stuff to understand? Not really. Today I want to show that there are better ways to represent that information in a way that is, you know, more meaningful and more easier to grasp. Let's break this wall of data, shall we? So data consists of mainly two elements. One is samples, which can be you know, Facebook users, patients in a clinical trial, or public presentations, such as this one. And also the features, which are measurements or indexes related to each one of those samples, such as like likes on Facebook pages, the side effects of a particular drug, or even, you know, the tone of my voice during this presentation. Now, if we're talking about evaluating one or two of those features, you all know how to do that. You all use Excel. You know how to do the bar graphs and histograms. Now, what happens if you have to deal with 10, 20, 30, 100 of those features at the same time? That's much, much more difficult. Even though every single one of you are doing that right now, you're all ranking my presentation. You're taking into account tons of different features, and then your brain is doing the decision making of good or bad. Now, I do the same thing with data, but I use visual cues. I use this guy, generative topographic mapping. So the idea here, like if you imagine that your data is like a landscape, where you have your mountains as your peaks, your good presentations, and your valleys are your bad presentations, this methodology can actually investigate that landscape and over time create a map that will give you like a region of good presentations and a region of bad. But I can even go deeper, I can dig further. I can also tell you, for example, valleys with purple flowers or valleys with yellow flowers. Or in the same way, I can translate that map even further and find the bad presentations which have, let's say, bad because of the voice, or bad because of the arguments, or even bad because of your confidence. Now, of course, I'm lying here. This is not real data about good and bad presentations. I'm a chemical engineer, after all. This is actually data about chemical plants. Now, what do those blue points mean? Pretty much now, what I'm saying is that the blue ones are just points where my system is okay, my plant is fine, there's nothing going wrong. And red, it's all my problems, things that I need to act upon quickly, different scenarios which I need to solve a certain problem. Now, the features for my system now are all those different measurements that I have, which are pretty much like tons of different sensors within my plant. And the samples, if you imagine this chemical plant as a video, are the frames that go, you know, over time and reveal me different sets of measurements. So we actually implemented that, and we offer that now to chemical plants and to people working there, so they can easily visualize the process and not only say things are going well or things are going bad, but they can tell it's going bad because of problem A, B, or C. So basically what I'm showing you today is that we can get a very, very, very complex problem, and we can bring that down into a 2D, easy to understand map. And, well, it does sound a little bit like science communication, doesn't it?